personal log. After successfully commanding landing and surveying operations on four of the five Julian moons, I'm taking the captain's prerogative and landing, personally, on Tylo, the biggest and most prestigious moon in the system. Having successfully made landfall, where no Kerbal has gone before, I realize I may be in some trouble. Kerbin Space Center, we have a problem. Can you get Werner on the horn?
Yeah, spacecraft Führer. What is the issue?
This is Jebediah. I believe Bill prefers Captain. Anyway, he made it down to the surface Tylo, which is why I need to know the specifications of the science lander. The landing craft seats von Kerbal is equipped with many scientific instruments driven by four Rapier engines for both oxygen breathing and closed cycle operations, and is capable of landing or taking off from any of the four moons of Joule. I mean five moons of Joule. I keep forgetting Tylo. It even has enough delta V to take off from that horrendous gravity well. I think I see the issue. Landing or taking off? What about landing and taking off? Doesn't that require a lot more fuel? Gott in Himmel! So, Dr. Von Kerman, tell me your plan to bring back that blowhard Bill. We plan to send a 28-ton Ketin mining rover to rendezvous with Bill coming on the surface. Fill up the landing craft so it can take off into orbit. I see. But isn't the next launch window in over 2 years? Yeah, meet a standard Holman transfer taking almost 3 years. Bill cannot wait that long. The overtime would kill the budget. So instead, we plan to build a giant rocket mid at least 20,000 meters a second of delta V in orbit. I estimate it will weigh close to 3,000 metric tons. I present to you, Project Overkill. How could we possibly launch something that large? Unless we do multiple launches, and assemble in orbit. Wunderbar! Exactly, Herr President! We will launch the rescue craft on core capable of deorbiting at Tylo. Then we will launch not two, not four, but six booster stages and dock them all in low carbon orbit. Won't that be outrageously expensive? You forget, Herr President, this is only version 0.235 of Kerbal Space Program. Budgets won't be introduced until version 0.24 mid-contracts. Money is no object. But you just said overtime would kill the
planet. When the 49 nuclear rockets will light up the Kerbin sky with more delta Vs than God! And I shall name it the Prometheus!
Ah, after the Titan that stole fire from the gods. Very appropriate.
9. After the left arm of the Macross and the space carrier from Stargate SG-1.
Well, at least it wasn't after that horrible Ridley Scott movie. Literally unwatchable. Bill will be happy to hear that the ground test of the Prometheus lander went well.
I performed the calculations and design mostly with Excel. In fact, he wants to say hello.
Excel Kerman here, Commander. I just want to say it's an honor to help you guys out. I just hope I don't screw up again.
What do you mean by again?
Well, back to work. We need to mount this thing on the top of a giant rocket.
Auf Wiedersehen.
After all of these hours of calculations and assembling, we are finally ready to launch the Prometheus core and lander.
SAS on, RCS on. Counting down. 3, 2, 1, ignition. Prometheus lifts off the first part of orbital assembly to rescue Bill Kerman. Eventually, liftoff mass of 2,078 tons. Already the first set of 12 asparagus stage boosters have been shed. We have Miko and are on course for 100 kilometer orbit. Circularization burn commencing.
Steht sie da und wartet auf den Start. Alles klar, Experten schalten sich um ein paar Daten. Die Crew hat dann noch ein paar Fragen doch. Der Countdown läuft.
Just have a little fuel left over in the mammoth rocket stage.
Excellent. We will use it to help meet the ejection burn. Now let's prepare the boosters for launch und docking.
trip to the moon, and she won't be back too soon. She doesn't write me and I can't sleep. All I hear from her is, my baby's up in a rocket machine. Since she left, she ain't been seen. She doesn't call me and I can't sleep. All I hear from her is,
Dr. Von Kerman, system check show we're missing the cathane tank. Without it, we cannot make fuel. Pull up the launch telemetry. Yeah, it looks like it exploded on takeoff. We can replace it on the next booster launch. Final booster docking complete. Proceeding with EVA to replace external cathane manifolds. First tank tapped successfully, retrieving the second tank. Ow! KSC, I have a problem. My EVA thrusters aren't calibrated for the new center of mass. Ooh! I cannot compensate. I think I may have knocked out the solar panel. Just knock out the other side! That way it's symmetrical. Oh! Jettison the tank! No need for another rescue! Besides, we only need one tank! Roger that, KSC. Proceeding with structural reinforcement, EVA. Completing EVA. Finally, the Prometheus is complete. According to my calculations, there should be 22,736 meters per second of Delta V available, not including the final descent fuel in the lander. There's still some fuel left in the mammoth lifting stage that is usable, but filling them to capacity would take too long and only add a few hundred meters per second of Delta V. We have plotted a straight line course to Joule, mid-intercept in 314 days. The discovery took 3 orbits to accumulate enough velocity to reach Joule in 800. Very impressive, Werner. You had a busy week. Bill is anxiously awaiting its arrival. When do you launch? Now!